Welcome back, dearies, to Sinfully Desilicious. Any guess on the next tea district of Tamil Nadu and its native recipe? Let me reveal it for you. It's our own rice bowl of Tamil Nadu, Tanjavur or Tanjung, and its pride Kadapa, coming in line after my previous tea district recipes, Tirunelveli Sudhi and Theni Kutisaran. Though Kadapa has no clear origin, it's deeply rooted in the Tanjore Kumbakonam region, entrenched in the arts of its natives. What is Kadapa? It's a subtle aromatic gravy prepared from a specially ground masala, thickened with moong dal and potatoes, then gently tempered with allspices. It's a vegan, gluten-free recipe, quick and easy to prepare as well. Now let's jump into the recipe. Take a mixer jar, add all the old spices mentioned along with ginger garlic, fried gram, green chili, coriander leaves and grated coconut. Grind it into a smooth paste, adding little warm water. Actually, the recipe calls for poppy seeds, which is kaskasa in Tamil. Due to unavailability, I skipped adding it in the ground masala. Adding it imparts a nutty flavor and acts as a thickening agent to the gravy. But add it in a limited quantity, like half to 1 teaspoon if it is available to you. Now heat a pan with oil of your choice and temper with bay leaf and star anise. Then add chopped garlic, shallots with a little salt, saute for a couple of minutes. Later add chopped tomatoes and chopped carrots, give a 2-minute stir. Meanwhile, wash and pressure cook moong dal. After it cools, mash the dal with a ladle. Similarly, pressure cook or steam one potato and mash it partially and keep it aside. Carrot and tomato are optional ingredients. Avoiding them will not affect the result. Then add the ground masala, partially mashed potatoes, finally the cooked mashed moong dal and combine it well. If you have pre-cooked moong dal in the refrigerator, this recipe is so handy that it can be prepared in a flash. Since I added turmeric powder, my kadapa was light yellow in color. You can skip adding turmeric powder to moong dal, which keeps your kadapa light cream in color. Now add 2 cups of water, stir it and let it boil in medium flame for 5 minutes. Later, simmer it for another 5 minutes on low flame. I would like to break a myth people saying Sodhi and Kadapa are the same. But it's absurd to say so, as these two curries have different ingredients and preparation. One common thing in both the curries is moong dal. The rest is completely disparate. Like Kadapa has ground masala and is tempered with old spices, whereas Sodhi has neither ground masala nor it's tempered with old spices. Kadapa has a few tablespoons of grated coconut in the ground masala, while in Sodhi only coconut milk is used. Tomato is optional in Kadapa, whereas tomato is completely avoided in Sodhi. Hope the difference between these two curries is more distinct now. You can also experience it when you prepare it at home following my recipe. Here I serve Tanjavur Kadapa with instant ragi rava dosa. Now let's get into its recipe. Instant tiffin is like a dream for anyone who spends time in the kitchen brainstorming for their next meal of the day. What's ragi rava dosa? It's a crepe-like lazy wafer dosa made from ragi or finger millet with rava and rice flour, spiced with ginger, green chili, pepper, cumin seeds. The exciting part of this tiffin is absolutely no soaking, no grinding, no fermentation. Also, it doesn't even need the 20-minute soaking given to any rava dosa. It's as simple as this. Mix, spread and flip your instant ragi rava dosa on your table within few minutes. Isn't it apt to say instant to this dosa? After whisking all the ingredients in the bowl, heat a non-stick tawa in high flame. Splash some water to make sure it's sizzling hot. Take a cup or bowl, mix the batter and scoop it. Pour it on the hot tawa at a height, starting from the edge, moving towards the center of the tawa. You shouldn't spread the batter like swirls in normal dosa. It should be dropped from a height. The reason to pour the batter at a height is to create that holes in the dosa, which enhances the crispiness in the dosa. After 2 minutes in low flame, dosa starts to leave the tawa, especially in the edges. Now glide the spatula gently on all sides first and then to the center to make sure that any part of the dosa is still stuck to tawa to avoid breaking. After flipping it carefully, drizzle oil if needed, cook for few seconds, then remove the dosa from the tawa. As I mentioned early, being an instant batter, it doesn't require any soaking time. Mix it, pour it and roast it. Even for my regular rava dosa or rava idli, I don't give any soaking time. The reason why I forsake the soaking time is, I feel rava gets absorbed with liquid and enlarge, which doesn't give that crispy, crunchy texture. When you pour the batter, tawa should be super hot. While cooking the dosa, it should be at low flame. Cooking the rava dosa needs a bit of patience as dosa has to be cooked on low flame. Each dosa will roughly take 3 minutes put together to cook on both sides. The reason why I included ragi in rava dosa is to make it healthy and nutritive. Try my ragi kelvaragu kali, which I accompanied with tene kutusare. Serve this ragi rava dosa with subtle aromatic Tanjavur kadapa. For more such interesting recipes, visit my website Sinfully Desilicious. When I discovered cooking, I discovered myself. So can you.